With only around 1,100 people and surrounded by 300,000 hectares of wetlands, this is St. Lucia. Some of the locals who've been living here for generations. Some were quite friendly and eager to meet new visitors. Others, not so much. Most of the locals, however, were just trying to mind their own business. This unique village provides the visitor with comfort, flexibility, and freedom to come and go with ease. The St. Lucia Estuary, home for around 800 hippopotamuses. It is one of the largest estuarine systems in Africa. And what better way to explore it than a boat cruise? Appearing seamlessly calm, hippopotamuses are known to become extremely aggressive when it comes to their territory. But they are not the only ones sharing these waters. Nile crocodiles. Over 1,100 crocodiles live in these waters. And somehow, they found a way to live in harmony with the hippos. Well, most of the time. St. Lucia forms part of the Isimangaliso Wetland Park and is one of the most biodiverse regions in all of Africa. A paradise flourishing with wildlife. Most herbivores, life here is good, and food is never too far. However, some mammals have found a more unusual method of obtaining their food. Infant vervet monkeys. They have learned that by staying close to humans, they would eventually find something tasty. But they also have some competition. Bandit mongooses are also aware of these streets. Yet, even as they search, they always remain cautious of their surroundings. As we reach Cape Vital Beach, it might be paradise for some, but it proves to be quite a harsh environment for others. Ghost crabs, taking on the full force of crashing waves. But why? why are they putting up with these rough conditions? Well, to find their food, of course. Exploring deeper into these wetlands, soon you'll encounter some of its incredible giants. The white rhinoceros. Dehorned for its protection. With only 20,000 left in the world, and over 1,000 being poached every year, these majestic creatures are in danger. When it comes to the black rhinoceros, only 5,000 remain in the wild, making them the most critically endangered. It will be up to us to help and save them. To help save our wildlife. In numbers, we can make a difference. And we certainly are able to make a change. Because our beautiful, complex, and biodiverse world is worth protecting.